Hi guys, welcome to Something Interesting. I've got something I believe rather very, very interesting this time around. And it's actually looking into the origin of these beautiful, innocent nursery rhymes. And like, who would think that this something almost ugly and diabolical behind some of the nursery rhymes? And there's some very, regular and famous nursery rhymes that I think all of us have sung growing up, and I don't know anybody who wouldn't know them. And the first one's Ring a Ring a Roses. And I remember when I was a, 3-4 year old, and I had my friends, and we'd go around in a circle and like, ring a ring a roses, a pocket full of poses, a tissue, we all fall down. And then we'd actually, like, you know, all of us would tumble down and we'd like, you know, fall. So yeah, good old days. But what do I know about this nursery rhyme rather than, you know, other than having some fantastic memories from my childhood? Well, this nursery rhyme actually dates back in history when there was the Great Plague in London, which was 1665, and it was the bubonic plague. And I'm sure most of you know of this Great Plague that hit London, and there was a 60% death rate, and almost nobody, you know, survived the plague. And it was a very, very violent plague. And Ring a Ring a Roses, why? Because you apparently got a very severe red rash, and it was followed by this violent sneezing. So a tissue, we all fall down. So it's actually talking about the plague. And why, a pocket full of poses is a pouch of sweet-smelling herbs, because they actually thought at that time that the plague was spreading because of bad smells. And at that point, they didn't really know there was the rats. And it was only when the Great Fire of London in 1666, when, you know, virtually all of London was burnt down, that the plague came to an end. So that was something very interesting about this very innocent and this very sweet nursery rhyme. There's another one. And again, all of us know this one. It's Jack and Jill. I don't think it gets any more basic than Jack and Jill. And it's Jack and Jill went up the hill. This one is like, you know, for this one, there are theories about it originating with the scene in France, where we're talking about King Louis and the famous Queen Marie Antoinette, where she said, give them cake, and the French Revolution. And it was basically Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water, and Jack fell down and broke his crown, which is basically, you know, broke his crown. And Jill came tumbling after, which was, I believe, 9 months after King Louis was beheaded. That was Queen Marie's turn. And she was sent to the guillotine. It was made palatable as a nursery rhyme much later, but in terms of its origin, it was 1793 when the actual beheadings took place, and this nursery rhyme came out sometime in 1795, and it also ties up in history and its origin. So who ever knew, while singing Jack and Jill went up the hill, that we're talking about, again, the very, very famous French Revolution. Surely enough, Jack lost his crown and Jill came tumbling after. The last one that I have is Mary, Mary, quite contrary, how does your garden grow? Again, a very famous one. And the Mary that is being alluded to is actually Queen Mary, the daughter of Henry VIII. She's famous, infamous for being Bloody Mary. And she was a staunch Catholic, and anyone who is not following her faith and believed in any other faith other than the Catholics, they were in trouble with Queen Mary, and basically they refer to the garden as a graveyard, and the talk of silver bells and cockle shells is basically the instruments used for torture, and the maids being in a row are basically instruments that were similar to the guillotine and used for beheadings. So Mary Mary, quite contrary, is actually talking of Bloody Mary and Queen Mary and the beheadings and the torture and all of that that transpired in history. So I thought that this was really, really, really interesting, at least for me, that these very innocent and these very happy nursery rhymes have something very dark and evil in their origin and their history. So that's a little something interesting for you this time around. I'll catch you guys soon. Bye. Thank you.